Hello guys and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I want to share with you how to do live stream on Facebook and on YouTube. I used to use a very cool software called the OBS or Open Broadcaster software for this, both to run the live show directly. So you can download OBS by just going to your Google, opening your Chrome and just typing up OBS. And you can see it directly. You can see Open Broadcaster software. It's an open access software that you can easily download and install. You can just go ahead and open it. Let me go to my, I've downloaded mine and I've installed. Let me show you how to use it. OBS, you can see it over here. Just click to open. I've made a complete tutorial about how to use OBS in general. So you can go ahead and try it. Go ahead and try to watch it. I'll put the link in the description and over here you can just watch it to have a general overview about how to use the software. So once you open it, this is what you see, a blank canvas, and then down here with series of scenes and sources, which are devices and other actions that you've put under the same scene. Okay, and then these are audio mixer and audio controls over here, and then these are scene transitions in cases when you have to transit between scenes, maybe camera, between webcams and what they're about, and screen recording. You can give lectures with all these features enabled. Okay, and then you have the controls over here, major controls, how to start streaming, how to start recording, how to start virtual camera and all that, studio mode. Everything is being explained in that tutorial and you can find it very easily. So the first thing you need to do is to create a scene. Okay, when you come in, you just create a scene, which I have created one. You can enable the video over here, but let me just remove this. I can say yes to this. I remove this video. So you can create a scene. You can just create by coming here to click on this small button. Usually you have to have a single scene. Okay, so you can right click and rename it if you don't want. For example, I can say live streaming as the name of my scene. All right, so the next thing is to add a source. Okay, after defining your scene, like this one, we have it live stream. So we can add the source over here by just coming down here and clicking on this plus sign to add a source. Now I have a video that I want to play. Okay, I don't want to show myself. So I just want to put in a media source. Just select it and give it a name. Okay, so let's say a video. And we can click on OK. And then we define the path, just locate the file within our computer. And let's say I have that video saved in my document and all the way down to YouTube. And you can see it here, next level. So click on open to open it. And you can enable it to loop at the end of it all. Once it reaches the end, it can loop back. Okay. Use hardware decoding when available. I don't want to use any of this. I just want to show nothing when playback ends. Right, so right now I click on OK to accept this, and you can see the video. You can see the sizing. You can just right click over here, come to transform, and you can come to edit to screen, edit fit to screen over here, and you can see everything fitted to screen. So the next thing is to set up the streaming properties. You can set that from the control panel over here. You can just come all the way down to settings. You click on settings. And the first thing is you go to video, make sure your video basic canvas resolution is at 1920 by 1080. And then you can see the output scale resolution is 1920 by 1080. I usually scale or both at 16 by 9. And downscale filter, I don't need that. Common FPS, frame rate per second, I keep it at 30. And you can go to the output over here and check out the streaming. Everything is left at default. You can make sure the bitrate is about 6,000 kilobytes per second and everything. The profile should be high. And you can come to stream over here. You just select, make sure you select Facebook Live, leave the server at default. And then you have to have the stream key. The stream key, you can have it by just coming back to your Facebook. You go to your Facebook, you log in, and then you can come to live video over here. And you select the first one, go live, and then you have the option to either go with camera or you can go ahead with and stream directly with streaming software. So right now I'm going to stream from the stream software, and it will give you this stream key. So just copy this stream key and then go back to the software and paste this stream key over here. You just select this and paste. You can show if you want to show the key, or you can hide, and then you can just come down here and hit on apply and say okay to this. And you can start streaming directly. Okay, so start streaming. You can see it has started the streaming, and you can come down to the Facebook and see it. So you just give it streaming a title. So let's say video tutorial. Okay, so the description, you can say teaching OBS. And then you can go ahead and click on go live over here. So once you click on go live, you can see the live video is starting. Okay, you can see the features and everything is playing perfectly. This is where you see the comments, and this is where you see the inserts such as the viewers, the reactions, the clips and comments and shares. You can see from here and you can do all that. You can see the metrics also over here, depending on how many people joined and what are their behaviors, they leave, they stay. You can have all that from here. So you can end the live video and you can confirm to end it, or to give you the option to either view the post or trim your video or create a clip from your video, or you can delete and return to newsfeed. Okay, you can do all that accordingly. If you want, you can delete the video. If you want, you can trim it, or if you want, you can create a clip out of that video. This is how to set the video on your Facebook. You can go ahead and do that on YouTube as well. So you can click on, you come down to the settings over here as well, and then you can come to output settings this time, and then you can come to recording. You can just check the custom recording, type of recording. You can say it's custom recording, and you can say output. Okay, output type, you can say output to URL, and you can start and can type the URL from here. And then for you to get this URL address, you have to go back to your YouTube channel. For example, you can come back to this channel and so for example, you come back to my channel and you want to go live, you just click on create and you say go live. So once you're on the live page over here, you can just come down here and see there's the stream URL, and then there's the stream key over here. So you can copy the stream URL. That's the first step. Copy the stream URL. You just copy it and then come back to OBS. You can stop this streaming if you want, but you can keep it also to continue if you want. And then you can come down here, make sure you're on recording. You come to file path. Okay. So just select it and paste the URL and then put a forward slash. Then you go back to the YouTube again and just copy the stream key. Okay, so just get the difference. The previous one, we copied the stream URL. Now you're copying the stream key and coming back to the same OBS forward slash. You just paste the stream key right now. Okay, so make sure the container format is set to MP4. You can set to any format, but MP4 is the best, which is H.264. You can leave everything at default. The video bitrate, you can set it to 4000 or between 3500 to 6000. You can keep it at 4000, it's okay. And you can come to apply over here and you can come to okay, keeping everything at default. And you can start recording, and this starting recording will start the YouTube video live directly from here. Okay, so once you hit on start recording, you can see it has started the recording, and the video is going to start going live. Okay, but right now it is live. Okay, so you can see it, and you can see the video, it will just start playing. Okay, so you can see the video, it is now live. Okay, you can see it is now live. So this is it, and you can see the other properties over here. So you can end the streaming if you want. You just end the streaming because this is just a test. You can end this. Okay, you can say next. You can edit the video in the studio, or you can just dismiss this. You can come back here and say stop recording to stop completely. All right, so ladies and gentlemen, this is a bit about how to stream live on Facebook and on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.